That's right, today on the show we're going to party like it's 1989. Let's test out some podium work here. Dancing around, not having much fun. As soon as you hop on the podium, all right, now I'm having a good time. Today on Rewind, we look at a very interesting chapter in Australian dance history. That's right, during the years 1987 to 1990, the Hordern Pavillion in Sydney was the venue for groundbreaking dance parties, the like of which has not been seen since. Different groups put on shows for up to 12,000 people each weekend. There was the fun parties, rat parties, you can see some of the posters behind us now, sweatbox, bacchanalia, black parties, even Colette played there. And I must warn you, there's adult language and very adult concepts. In fact, I can't get my head around about half the things on this show today, I'll tell you, so watch out for that. At that time, Charles Amsden, sitting down here, hi Charles, and his friend, attempted to make a market a video magazine called Video Manic. Now, we failed. But this documentary has been gathering dust in a milk crate at Charles' mum's place for a while now. In fact, last week, 10 years later, Charles found it. Snappy work, Charles. As well as fringe skirts, Rick Astley suits and very glazed eyes. I'll be showing you some of the clips around then, like pump up the volume, pump up the jam, and of course, Guru Josh! He always, yeah, people love Guru Josh. 1999, time for Guru, I say. But let's look at the fashion and the foolishness that was 1989 at the Hordern Pavillion in Sydney. Oh, by the way, did I mention my haircut?
First, let's party!
Get on it. Boogity to the rhythm of the beat. Boogity to the rhythm of the beat. Boogity to the rhythm of the beat. Boogity to the rhythm of the beat.
And what's the most important thing about dance parties, you think?
Having fun.
Right. How much fun is it? Like fun till you puke or what?
No, it's fun till you go home at 4 o'clock on a Sunday afternoon.
What do you do at dance parties when you go there?
Dance till I fall over and then see how it goes.
What times the falling over usually happen?
About 5 o'clock.
What made you decide to come along to a dance party?
To listen to good music, just to get out of it and have a good time.
Are you with a large group of people or are you venturing out on your own?
About 25 of us.
25?
Yeah.
Why suddenly think, hey, I want to get in a room with 5,000 other sweaty people? What made you suddenly come to that conscious decision?
Because I love sweat.
Yeah. And the noise too, the sound, you know, it's really
cool. What, the noise of sweat, the smell of sweat?
Just sweat.
The touch of sweat.
What's the biggest thing about dance parties you like?
The dancing, the music, the atmosphere, the people.
The sweat?
No, not the sweat.
Now, you're actually lying on the floor, you're not actually doing a lot of dancing. You having a good time?
Yeah.
Is this what, yeah, do you come to me dance parties?
Yeah.
Now, Jack, a lot of people would like to blame you at starting this whole dance party thing.
I'll take full responsibility, absolutely. Why not? Yeah, sure.
Then, when was the first one you kicked off in that garage all those years ago?
I'm talking about October 83, that's 6 years ago.
Now, why did you eventually start the whole thing?
Well, look, my parties at home got too big, and look what's happened now.
You had the major events, the Mardi Gras and the Seas Ball, which we used to spend 6 months of the year looking forward to. I mean, I remember like walking out of a Seas Ball and thinking, 6 months, the next party. Now, most kids of the party season that's on now couldn't believe that they're used to a party every weekend.
And what we wanted to do with Bacchanalia was to provide a dance party like the Mardi Gras, which was for everybody, for the general public, not just for the gay community. And so it was called Bacchanalia because I was a student of the ancient Dionysian mysteries.
Oh, right. And Bacchus, the god of woohoo!
Yeah, Bacchus, the god of wine, the god of theatre, the god of drama, the god of ecstasy.
Every party is a risk. You've just got to have the right idea, hit the market at the right time. And sure, you can make money, but you can also lose a lot of money.
Well, you're looking at up front about $20,000, but you're putting your head on the block for about $80,000. So you've got to get $80,000 worth of ticket sales just to pay your bills.
I work 15 hours a day, 5 days a week.
And what do you do to get that sort of money to come here?
I just sell jeans.
Well, who'd you borrow from?
Well, I actually borrowed from my mum. Right. And she's not rich, but she just had to sort of give me whatever she had.
Right, and your mum come along? How did you convince your mum to actually give you money? Did you, like, sort of flash some lights, play some acid house music to her and say, mum, is that how it happened?
No, I suppose she sort of believed in me. I mean, you know, I've been DJing for 10 years and I've had a good profile and lots of stuff, and she probably believed in what we were going to do.
On your Mrs. Holden, what a woman.
Hi, Maynard here for Video Maniac. You've just arrived at the dance party. What is your expectations of the evening?
Good night out.
Would you like to put your hat on so we can see what the full outfit looks like?
Not really.
Oh, come on. Look at that. Nice shorts, nice socks, neat, clean. You'll be ruined in about half an hour, I reckon.